loving us all beyond expression, look with compassion on us and on this holy church, O Master, and show us to those who pray with us the riches and return of mercy. For to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, is due all glory, honor, and worship, now and ever and forever.
To the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. two of us, one by breaking down the barrier of the hostility that kept us apart. In his own flesh, he abolished the law with its commands and precepts to create himself one new man from us who had been two, and to peace, reconciling both of us to God in our body through the cross, which put the enemy to death. He came and announced the good news of the peace to you who were far off and to those who were near. Through him, we both have access in one spirit to the Father. That means that you are strangers and aliens no longer. No, you are fellow citizens of the saints and the members of the household of God. You form a building which rises on the foundation of the apostles, prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the capstone. Through him whose structure is fitting together and takes shape as a holy temple in the Lord, in him you are being built the temple to become the dwelling place for God in the Spirit.
The Savior is God's word, wisdom be attentive. Sell them? Did he live off of them? Maybe he did both. We can guess and assume that he lived off of them, because as soon as he built the bigger barns, he decided to basically retire. And these crops, these grains and goods that he is storing, they don't have a very long shelf life. The idea that he's going to live off of them for the rest of his life is already foolish. He had extra harvest. He didn't exactly win the lottery. In the gospel accounts, we see Jesus constantly telling us to use the gifts from God wisely. He even teaches us to use our money wisely. Yes, he even says that money can lead to a lot of trouble. But money itself is never the problem. What's really the problem is how we use it. So the rich man clearly was blessed one year, and he concluded that he had made it. Imagine if I got a nice fat Christmas bonus, and then I decided to retire. No matter how great the bonus was, unless it was millions of dollars, there's no way it could help me in the long term. We are continuously blessed with gifts from God. Sometimes we're even blessed with extra gifts. But what do we do with them? How do we use them for the glory of the kingdom of God? You've probably heard the saying, live each day as it was the last day of your life. While we probably understand the sentiment of the saying, it's not really very practical. And if I know for sure today is the last day of the rest of my life, there is a lot of things I would do. But it's very hard to live every day like that. Yet there's something to the saying. Every day we're capable of small yet smart acts. Every day we can manage our daily gifts or blessings for the greater glory of Jesus and God, for our salvation, and for the benefits of those who are around us that need help. God asked the rich fool, these things you have prepared, whose will they be? The things that we prepare, whose will they be? The acts of our daily life, do they witness to the fact that we've already been saved, or to the fact what we really want is to relax, eat, drink, and be merry? Each and every action, each and every thought, each and every word is a treasure that's stored that makes us rich either for ourselves or towards God. We need to decide towards what or whom we desire to be rich. And we need to realize that this decision has very real consequences. And then simply work towards that goal with these gifts and resources that we're given. My prayer for each and every one of us tonight is that we utilize our gifts for God for the purpose of our life. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to Christ.
Slava Jesus.
Slava Jesus.
Lord, look down with merciful eyes on your servants who with faith have
and death to eternal life by grace. We pray, O generous Creator of all, hear and have mercy.
Thank you.
love of God and Father and communion in the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit. Truly love.
Preserve the pre-holy churches in peace, safety, honor, and health for many years as they faithfully impart the word of your truth.
And remember all your people.
Remember those in your offerings and do good deeds in your holy churches. Remember those, remember the poor and above all. Send out your mercies and grant that we with one voice and one heart may glorify and praise the most honored and magnificent name. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, all of our
Jesus Christ, to the
believeth about us.
And you are truly Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners from the land of the curse. Accept me today as a partaker of your mystical supper, O Son of God, for I will not reveal your mysteries to your enemies, nor will I give you a kiss as the Jews. Alike I can bless you. Remember me, O Lord, when you come in your kingdom. Remember me, O Master, when you come in your kingdom. Remember me, O Holy One, when you come in your kingdom.
Master, you are the God of gods and the Lord of mercy, who released us from the punishment of our forefathers' curse by your life-giving passion. By your life-giving resurrection from the dead, you raised the fallen with you, and you burst open the ravenous belly of Hades, taking the captive by the throat, tearing up the written body of our sins. Enlighten our hearts by your inexhaustible light, and grant that we may rise from sleep to worship you with compulsion of soul. For you are our salvation, and to you belongs glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
The 2023 envelopes and calendars are ready, so they are available for you to pick up. Please do so between now and Christmas, or now and at least January 1st, okay? St. Nicholas weekend, St. Nicholas celebration party is on Sunday, 2 weeks from tomorrow. We don't have a sign-up sheet out in the church, but what we've been doing is emailing you the bulletin, and also in this week's take-home bulletin, there's a clip and return registration form. You can put your name on it, how many people are attending, clip it out, drop it in the collection basket, or you can simply email your response back. I don't know how many of you are nice. Three of you. Good. How many are naughty? None of you. Okay, well, everybody is known by St. Nicholas, and I think we're all kind of a combination, and St. Nicholas does really know whether we're naughty or nice. If we're nice, God bless us. If we're naughty, what's the one thing we all have to do? Say a good act of contrition and say, I'm sorry. And that wipes away a multitude of sins through the grace of our Holy Father Nicholas. So we are having a St. Nicholas celebration, much in the tradition that we've done so in previous years. The former Athletic Association of St. Thomas will be preparing their very wonderful pork dinner. And a special treat for the kids. We will have a visit from St. Nicholas himself, live and in person. He'll be here in church and also in the hall. We'll have some music and festivities. It's just a nice day to break bread as a parish family. I do hope, and I pray that you can all make it. You can make this St. Nicholas Day a very, very special one. So please, do a friend, sign up for that, okay? Those of you guys who are watching my live streaming as well, please, if you want to attend, get that registration back, okay? Thanksgiving is this week. And what's the most important thing that we have to do for Thanksgiving?
Hi.
Give thanks through prayer. That's exactly right. So Wednesday evening, the vigil of Thanksgiving, we will have a divine liturgy of Thanksgiving here in church at 7 o'clock. If you have absolutely nothing for which to be grateful, by all means, stay home. If you have something for which you are grateful and you want to express your gratitude to God, then come and offer your prayers of thanksgiving on Wednesday evening here in church at 7 o'clock, okay? And we're also going to have a small kind of special prayer service asking God for all the blessings and thanking God for all the blessings, good and sometimes surprising, sometimes a bad blessing is a good blessing in disguise. That have come our way this year. We have a holy day this week. Other than Cantor George or Cantor Doreen, Father Tom or Deacon, anybody else know which holy day it is?
Entrance of the Theotokos.
What is it?
Entrance of the Theotokos.
Entrance of the Mother of God, Feast of the Blessed Mother on Monday. On Monday, so we'll celebrate the Divine Liturgy for The Blessed Mother's Holy Day, the feast of her entrance into the temple on Monday at 10 o'clock. And also tomorrow, you know, you can't come back tomorrow. Did you know that? Okay, it's not like you punch your ticket only once and you can't return. But tomorrow you can come back because tomorrow we are having a Thanksgiving luncheon. I don't mean Thanksgiving because of Thanksgiving week. I mean Thanksgiving because we are grateful for all the helpers and the patrons who recently assisted us at our Slavic festival. So we're going to have a reveal party, as it were, revealing the revenue from the festival income. That's going to be distributed tomorrow. We'll have a presentation. And also we're going to have some halloumi and pierogi. Byzantine soul food will be available tomorrow, right after the liturgy, okay? There's no charge to attend. You don't have to sign up to attend, but if you want to attend, we'd be certainly happy to have you. I think that's it for the announcements. God willing, we will see you, pray God, if not Monday. I really do hope on Wednesday evening, so that we can offer our prayers of Thanksgiving, okay? Glory to Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to whom Christ, our God, our hope, glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Mother of God. So let's think about the prayer that we have in our hearts.